and in his name all oppression shall cease. Sweet hymns of joy in grateful chorus raise we, let all within us praise his holy name. Christ was born. Oh, night divine, oh, night. Oh, night divine.
Good evening, and welcome to our celebration of the Feast of the Holy Family within this season of Christmas. A warm welcome to all who may be visiting us today. Please make sure that your cell phone is off as we are about to begin Holy Mass with hymn number 86, Hark the Herald Angels Sing, song number 86. Please rise.
Joyful all ye nations, rise, join the triumph of the skies. With angelic hosts proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Christ by highest heaven adore, Christ the everlasting Lord. Late in time behold him come, offspring of the virgin womb. Veiled in flesh the Godhead see, hail the incarnate deity. Pleased as man with men to dwell, Jesus our Emmanuel. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Hail the heaven Prince of Peace, righteousness, light and life to all he brings, risen with healing in his wings. Mild he lays his glory by, born that we no more may die, born to raise us from the earth, born to give a second birth. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace and peace of God our Father, the love of the Lord Jesus Christ, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, on this solemn feast of the Most Holy Family, let us acknowledge our sins, particularly times we have failed to live that kind of love that should characterize all the sons and daughters of God. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You are Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are the Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King. O God, almighty Father, glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. For you alone are the Holy One. Alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ. the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good
Let us pray. O God, who were pleased to give us the shining example of the Holy Family, graciously grant that we may imitate them in practicing the virtues of family life and in the bonds of charity, and so in the joy of your house, delight one day in eternal rewards. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the first book of Samuel. In those days, Hannah conceived, and at the end of her term bore a son, whom she called Samuel, since she had asked the Lord for him. The next time her husband, Elkanah, was going up with the rest of his household to offer the customary sacrifice to the Lord and to fulfill his vows, Hannah did not go, explaining to her husband, "Once the child is weaned, I will take him to appear before the Lord and to remain there forever. I will offer him as a perpetual Nazarite." Once Samuel was weaned, Hannah brought him up with her, along with a 3-year-old bull, an ephah of flour, and a skin of wine, and presented him at the temple of the Lord in Shiloh. After the boy's father had sacrificed the young bull, Hannah, his mother, approached Eli and said, "Pardon, my lord, as you live, my lord. I am the woman who stood near you here praying to the Lord. I prayed for this child, and the Lord granted my request. Now I, in turn, give him to the Lord. As long as he lives, he shall be dedicated to the Lord." Hannah left Samuel there. The word of the Lord.
Blessed are they who dwell in your house, O Lord. Blessed are they who dwell in your house, O Lord. How lovely is your dwelling place, O Lord of hosts. My soul yearns and pines for the courts of the Lord. My heart and my flesh cry out for the living God. Blessed are they, blessed are they who dwell in your house, O Lord. Happy are they who dwell in your house. Continually they praise you. Happy the men whose strength you are. Their hearts are set upon the pilgrimage.
Blessed are they, blessed are they who dwell in your house, O Lord.
O Lord of hosts, hear our prayer.
Hearken, O God of Jacob. O God, behold our shield, and look upon the face of your anointed.
Blessed are they, blessed are they, who dwell in your house, O Lord.
A reading from the first letter of Saint John. Beloved, see what love the Father has bestowed on us, that we may be called the children of God. And so we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we shall be has not yet been revealed. We do know that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Beloved, if our hearts do not condemn us, we have confidence in God and receive from him whatever we ask, because we keep his commandments and do what pleases him. And his commandment is this: we should believe in the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, and love one another just as he commanded us. Those who keep his commandments remain in him, and he in them. And the way we know that he remains in us is from the Spirit he gave us. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia,
alleluia, alleluia. Let the peace of Christ control your hearts. Let the word of Christ dwell in your richly.
Alleluia,
alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Each year, Jesus' parents went to Jerusalem for the feast of Passover, and when he was 12 years old, they went up according to festival custom. After they had completed its days, as they were returning, the boy Jesus remained behind in Jerusalem, but his parents did not know it. Thinking that he was in the caravan, they journeyed for a day and looked for him among their relatives and acquaintances, but not finding him, they returned to Jerusalem to look for him. After 3 days, they found him in the temple, sitting in the midst of the teachers, listening to them and asking them questions. And all who heard him were astounded at his understanding and his answers. When his parents saw him, they were astonished. And his mother said to him, "Son, why have you done this to us? Your father and I have been looking for you with great anxiety." And he said to them, "Why were you looking for me? Did you not know that I must be in my Father's house?" But they did not understand what he said to them. He went down with them and came to Nazareth and was obedient to them. And his mother kept all these things in her heart. And Jesus advanced in wisdom and age and favor before God and man. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. The reason the world does not know us is it didn't know him. To put that another way, I ask you to think for a minute. Does everybody know you? Now, to clarify the word know, I'll use a different word that will help you to get it. Does everybody get you? If your answer is yes, question your Christianity. Does everybody get you? Does everybody get why you do certain things and do not do certain things? Does everybody get when you live by the truth that right is still right even if no one's doing it, and wrong is still wrong even if everyone's doing it? Do some people not get you when you have a little more concern of a kingdom that is not of this world than to compete in the kingdom of this world that passes? See, that's what John is getting at. The reason the world doesn't get us is they didn't get him. If we always have to exert our power, if we always have to be noticed, if we always have to have the big and the showy, then we didn't get him. He entered human history through the back door. The inn is where people would meet to discuss politics, to kind of push their weight along. Just like today, there would be the 5-star or the 4-star and the prestige of one or the other. That was the gathering place for the things of the world. And yet the Savior of the world came to a stable. Does the world get you? When the wisdom you consult is not what happens to be politically correct or popular at the present time? If we conform ourselves to the world, then we see the deformation of the human family. Jesus chose to be born within a family, and it wasn't a perfect one. A family whose plans were altered when they found out about the coming of a child. But a child who was seen as one to cherish, not as a choice. A child who in our own world many times is not a blessing, but is seen as a burden. Where some would say they have the right to determine that some can die. They must die so that others can live the way they want. If we don't buy into that, there should be some people who don't get us. When was the last time, those of you who have children, had your kids say, well, it's not like that in so-and-so's house, or their parents say it's okay, and what you're doing is standing for a moral truth or a lasting value? When was the last time you've been able to say, well, not in this house, or so-and-so isn't your mother? And the kid doesn't get it. And that's good, because they'll begin to. No, Christian families are not supposed to blend in. We deal with all the stuff, whether we are believers or not. Parents not always getting kids. We saw that with Jesus himself in that little episode in the temple. The struggle of not being able to provide everything you would like for your children. You think Joseph wanted his wife to give birth in a stable? To have the world around you be hostile to what you're trying to do. So sometimes we compromise or give up. There was nothing more hostile than Herod's hatred for the infant, and Joseph needing to take his wife and the infant Savior as a refugee into Egypt, out of fear for their life. So threats are not foreign. What do we do in the face of it? Public education today, our little toddlers will be taught, according to government standards, what marriage is. And it's completely the opposite of what God, the author of life and marriage, proclaims it to be. How will young people know the value of purity and chastity when they experience in their own lives the news that they're going to have a new brother and sister, but mom or dad doesn't necessarily have a spouse? Are our families different? And when we take the stand, we hold firm to be different. Some won't get it. So on this Holy Family Sunday, I just ask you to think about the choices, to think about the church that is your home, because nothing here can be built without the foundation that's there. So I guess I leave you with the fact of the question again. They didn't get him. Does everybody get you? I hope not. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, the maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. No matter how broken we may think our families are, no matter how less than ideal, we turn commonly to the Father of us all. He heals our wounds, he calls us to light, and invites us to his embrace. It's in that confidence that we bring these needs.
For the grace to truly linger in these Christmas days on the great gift we celebrate, and to be renewed in our desire to make the words of our love and faith visible in the choices we make each day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For families, for those who are challenged and in pain, for those who are in need, and for all who experience brokenness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For conversion in our society, for greater action to address violence, for greater sensitivity and outreach to those tormented by mental illness, and for healing for families who have been touched by senseless violence, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the blessing of homes where each strives to live for the good of the other and where all live for God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those separated from family due to military service, may they be safe and may we soon know peace in homecoming, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the needs in our books of intentions and in our hearts, for all those who have gone before us in death, especially the Cain and Mulville families for whom this Holy Mass is offered today, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. All this we ask confidently through Christ, Lord and brother, Savior of us all, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Please join in singing song number 96, Infant Holy, song number 96.
The babe is Lord of all. Christ the babe is Lord of all.
us were sleeping, shepherds keeping vigil till the morning dew. Saw the glory, heard the story, tidings of a gospel true. Thus rejoicing, free from sorrow, praises, voices, greet the morrow. Christ the babe is born for you. Christ the babe is born for you. As we journey to the stable, like the wise men long ago, we are hoping to discover what these pilgrims came to know. All are welcome at this manger, King and Shepherd, friend and stranger. Christ the babe is Lord of all. Christ the babe is Lord of all. Wake our spirits from their slumber, send the darkness on its way. Fill our hearts with joy and wonder on this blessed Christmas day. Songs of angels all around us, grace and blessing now surround us. Christ be with us as we go. Christ be with us as we go.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. We offer you, Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation, humbly asking that through the intercession of the Virgin Mother of God and of Saint Joseph, you may establish our families firmly in your grace and your peace. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the mystery of the Word made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that as we recognize in him God made visible, we may be caught up through him in love of things invisible. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke the bread, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he handed the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." A mystery of faith.
Save us, save us, Savior of the world. For by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Peter our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
You. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
You live in me and
have two special events for faith formation for adults coming up. The series, The Mystery of God by Bishop Robert Barron, begins on Tuesday, January 5th. There'll be both morning and evening sessions. There's a form to register in the bulletin. Very important that you register and get it back to us by Friday, since materials have to be prepared. So it starts a week from Tuesday mornings or evenings, The Mystery of God. It's a wonderful six-week series, but don't forget to pre-register. In the bulletin, there's the form to just clip out and drop either in the basket when you come for Mass on New Year's Day, the Holy Day, or mail it into the office. On January 9th, we have a special evening of reflection for women called Amazing Grace. There's food, fellowship, as well as faith formation. You need to get one of the flyers to register for that. They are in the little gathering area between the inside and outside doors, right beneath the bulletin board. So as you go into that little vestibule to your right under the bulletin board, grab one of the flyers, ladies, and enjoy an evening together of food, fellowship, and faith formation, January 9th. So that deadline is the end of this week, too. Later this week, as we enter the civil holiday, New Year's, in the church, it is the solemn feast of Mary, Mother of God, and the World Day of Prayer for Peace. You'll notice the Mass schedule for New Year's Eve and New Year's Day in the bulletin. And since I have been here, we have had the tradition to spend the last half hour of the old year and the first half hour of the new before the Lord in the Blessed Sacrament. This will be the 31st time as a priest that I've done that. I've always made it my intention, extending the invitation to parishioners, and if nobody came, I told them that I would be there to pray the parish through the last half hour and into the new year. It's been great to see people who have made this New Year's Eve alternative. So I invite you to consider joining us. It's very simple. It's very thought-provoking. We come in the presence of Jesus himself. The blessing is given at the stroke of midnight. So that's New Year's Eve, 11:30 to 12:30 is the holy hour. And since New Year's is around the corner, we have parish calendars for you. They're beautiful. They have the many faces of Pope Francis, and all of them are full of joy. So I invite you to take a calendar as a token of our appreciation for all your support. They're on the heating units between the doors, and nestled between them are the brochures, for Catholics can always come home. It was wonderful to see so many people take these to give to family members who seldom, if ever, practice their Catholic faith. We're asking each one to reach at least one person. If you don't want to get involved, put it in an envelope, mail it to them anonymously, put our return address on it. If they want to complain, I'll talk to them. Believe me, the whole theme is called Let's Talk. But I would suggest maybe you want to write a little note. Hey, saw these in church, thought of you. No pressure, I'm praying for you. If you're interested and you want me to come with you, I will. The end of January, we're going to have a simple gathering next door at the house called Let's Talk. Start making our way back. As I said at Christmas, this is about relationship, not religion. As soon as we get that, it makes all the difference. So if you didn't get a brochure on Christmas, they're in those little baskets between the calendars. Don't take a freebie without taking the brochure. Okay, you got to do a little work and you get a free calendar. There's a lot more. It's all in the bulletin. Let us pray. Bring those who refresh with this heavenly sacrament, most merciful Father, to imitate constantly the example of the Holy Family, so that after the trials of this world we may share their company forever, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Please join in singing song number 81, Angels We Have Heard on High, song number 8-1.
Angels we have heard on high, sweetly singing o'er the plains, and the
nations in reply echo back their joyous strains. Gloria in excelsis Deo, gloria in excelsis Deo. Shepherds, why this jubilee? Why your joyous strains prolong? Say, what may the tidings be which inspire your heavenly song? Gloria in excelsis Deo, gloria in excelsis Deo. Come to Bethlehem and see him whose birth the angels sing. Come adore on bended knee Christ the Lord, the new